Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.2, Problem 4. This is Section 10.2, Problem number 4. It says a local scientist is concerned that the sand at Horseneck Beach in Westport is washing away. The American Meteorological Society records indicate that wave swells at Horseneck Beach during storms have an average height of mu equal to 6.4 feet, with a standard deviation of sigma equal to 1.8 feet. A study conducted from 2014 to present indicate that a sample of 36 storms had an average wave height of X bar equal to 6.6 feet. Is there enough evidence to support the claim that the average wave height is different, underlined, from what it has been in the past, usually a 0.05 level of significance? So this is a hypothesis test. It's a test where the population standard deviation is known. This is a six-step process. The first step of the six is state the null hypothesis. And the symbol for null hypothesis is a capital H with a subscript of 0. And it'll be mu. And it contains a condition of equality. It's either going to be equal to, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, and some number. And in this case, the value of mu that's given right in the problem is mu equals 6.4. That's step one. We have stated the null hypothesis. Step two, state the alternate hypothesis. So capital H subscript of 1. You're going to have mu, I'll leave a blank space, same number, 6.4, and you're either going to have a greater than, less than, or inequality sign. So which one is it in this case? Well, it's very clearly mentioned different. It's even underlined in the question. So different just means not equal to. Could be bigger, could be less. So not equal to. And the third step is determine what type of test you have. It could be a left-tail test, right-tail test, or two-tail test. Well, not equal to is the two-tail. And two-tail means you have a critical region in both ends, left and right, and we'll get to that as we get to step six. So, the step four is calculate the value of z. So our formula for z is x bar minus mu over sigma divided by the square root of n. So z equals x bar is 6.6, the average of the sample, minus mu, mu is 6.4, the average of the population, divided by sigma over square root of n. And sigma, the standard deviation for the population, is 1.8, square root of n. N is the size of the sample. So in this case, our sample has a size of 36. So n will be 36. Don't forget the square root. That's a fairly common mistake. It's not just 36 in the denominator, but square root of 36. So now let's start working on that computation. In the numerator, 6.6 minus 6.4 will be positive 0.2. And in the denominator, I'm going to have 1.8 over 6. Let me deal with that square root right away. So square root of 36 is 6 because 6 times 6 is 36. And let me simplify the denominator a little bit. I'm going to have 0.2 in the numerator. So 1.8 over 6 is 0.3. I can do that much without a calculator. I know 18 over 6 is 3. But because it's 1.8, not actually 18, it's 0.3. So now I can divide z equals 0.2 divided by 0.3. That's the same as 2/3. Even without a calculator, I know that's 2/3 is 0.666666. If you do it on a calculator, it'll almost fill the screen with sixes, and the last digit will be a 7. Or an easier way to write that is the digit that repeats with a bar over it. 0.6 with a bar means the 0.6s go on forever. So that was step four, compute the value of z. We took the formula for z, filled it in, got a value for z of 0.66666666. So step five is look up the value for z in the z chart, or a standard normal chart. So to look up something in the chart, you want to start by writing it so that it has two places after the decimal. I can't look up that many positions after the decimal, all those sixes. So the second one out is a 6. If I go one more, the third one also a 6. That's enough to make it a 0.67. So we want to look up 0.67. So The first step in looking something up is write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. We rounded it to 0.67. Positive 0.67, because it could be negative. So next, you want to split the number that you're going to look up into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the rightmost digit is a 7. It just comes off to the side. Then after that, you're going to put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So the 7 gets written as a 0.07. Then I go to the standard normal chart, or Z chart. I'm going to look in the positive 0.6 row, the 0.07 column. And you'll see the row and the column intersect at a value of 0.7486. That's step 5. Look up your value for Z in the standard normal chart. We looked it up, and the chart value is 0.7486. So step 6, the final step. State your conclusion. And your conclusion will either be worded reject the null or fail to reject the null. So if we reject the null, it seems that that wave height is likely a little different. That the wave height has changed, indicating some type of climate change, which probably means you are washing away the sand at Horseneck Beach. If you fail to reject the null, it's more likely that the wave height is still 6.4. Again, you're never positive. It's just what condition is more likely. So this is a two-tail test. So we will have a critical region in the left tail and the right tail. It's a 0.05 level of significance. So you have half of that 0.05, 2.5% in each tail. And the critical value to get into the right critical end would be 0.9750. And then this would be anything bigger than 0.025. So our chart value does not go into either critical end. 0.7486 is like in proportion somewhere, a little to the right of the middle, but not far out into the critical region. So in this particular case, there's not enough evidence to reject the null. We will fail to reject the null, meaning the null hypothesis is more likely to be true, that the wave height still has an average of 6.4 feet during storms. So my conclusion, fail to reject null.